Hello, I'm Maureen Cropper. I'm an environmental economist. I study the costs and benefits of policies to reduce local pollution, local air pollution, and also global greenhouse gas emissions, which cause global warming and climate change. In terms of availability of data, and not just big data through the internet, but also federal data sources and other sources of data, you can study almost anything, whether it's air pollution in Delhi or it's looking at the impact of the 2008 recession on households. We're just in a much better position to look at these issues than we were 20, 30 years ago. We have just really a stellar faculty, many of whom happen to be women, and I think that actually we've gotten there by just hiring the best people. We have about a third women, which is very unusual for a top economics department, but at the same time we have a very policy-oriented department, and actually a lot of our female faculty have held really important positions in government, in the private sector, at international financial organizations, and having all of that talent, that human capital, really, really strengthens the department. Getting a good grounding is important in terms of the mathematics and statistics you need, but then I would also say that you should acquaint yourself with the kinds of work that economists do, and I think the best way to do that is to look at what is being published in areas that interest you. There are many, many subfields in economics, and I would just suggest beginning to read what people are doing in those fields. I have been teaching in the economics department at Maryland for 40 years now. I have had many students, including many female students. I just wish, frankly, there were more of them. I wish that there were more women deciding to major in economics, and I would certainly be happy to work with them.